little piece of paper with all this stuff written down. And she read it for us. She said, these are things that I need to say to my family to let you know how much I love you. Because what happens a lot of times, you know, we go to a funeral, the person who's going to scream the loudest is the one who's probably the worst person in the family. Okay? I went to a funeral. I don't go to funerals, and I make no apologies for that. What I do, what I want to do, is remember whatever it was that we were doing the last time we were together. So for most of my family that's transitioned, I've never seen them in a party. I know that they're no longer with me, but I've never seen them in death. And I've been quite comfortable. So one day I went and I sat outside. And I knew when I heard the scream, "Wow, Mama, don't leave me, Mama!" It was my niece, who was probably the worst child that my aunt had. She was terrible, terrible. Okay. So my niece gave me this, and we've used it for years. So I want you to think about, who is it in your life that you need to say something to? Even if it's to say, "I don't like it," but you say it, you get it off of your mind. Because then you will say, if I knew that you weren't going to be here tomorrow, I would have said these things, okay? So, if I knew it would be the last time that I'd see you fall asleep, I would tuck you in more tightly and pray the Lord your soul to keep. If I knew it would be the last time that I'd see you walk out that door, well, I would give you a hug and a kiss, and I'd call you back for one more. If I knew it would be the last time I'd hear your voice lifted up in praise, well, I would videotape each action and word so I could play them back each day. If I knew it would be the last time I could spare an extra minute to stop and say, "I love you," instead of assuming you would know that I do. If I knew it would be the last time I would be there to share your day, well, I'm sure you'll have so many more, so I can just let this one slip away. For surely there's always tomorrow to make up for an oversight, and we always get a second chance to make everything right. There will always be another day to say our "I love you's." And certainly there's another chance to say anything I can do's. But just in case I might be wrong and today is all I get, I'd like to say, tomorrow is not promised to anyone, young or old alike. And today may be the last chance you get to hold your loved one tight. So if you're waiting for tomorrow, why not do it today? For if tomorrow never comes, you'll surely regret the day that you didn't take that extra time or smile or a hug or kiss. And you were too busy to grab someone what turned out to be their one last wish. So hold your loved ones close today and whisper in their ear. Tell them how much you love them and that you always hold them. Take time to say, "I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you, or it's okay." And if tomorrow never comes, you'll have no regret about it. This is written on the 1st January 2000. Have issues, have dresses, and then very often we wish that we could scream.